Yena!
Hello, everybody. I am Elin Rees, and today I'm at the wonderful Lake Ocean View in Painesville. And there's a gem of Painesville. It's really beautiful. And I am sitting with the one and only King Carol.
King.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
All right, you looking for help?
I'm in a desperate.
All right, so how have you been since you came from the U.S.?
No, it's good. It's all good. It's good to be back home. Yeah, work again. You know, normal thing.
I know, right? Yeah. Okay, so let's talk about your music career. You're one of the most talked about and also talented female artists in Liberia. We're celebrating Women Month, and you're breaking the bias because you're like up there with the other, with your male counterparts. When did you start doing music, or when did you realize that you wanted to do music?
So it all started almost 4 years ago. But initially it was kind of like an inborn something. I really used to like music growing up. It was like a therapy for me because I've been through a lot as a child. So every time, you know, I'm going through some things, I just like to sing my heart out, you know, listening to Calvin Gaye Adams, even Ibanez Camara, Bernice Blackie, you know, all these people, Picado, Yogi Blake songs. You know, it was just a mixture of different music.
Yeah.
Music that appeals into the soul, you know. I just sing my heart out, and then at school I sing, you know, just to keep the day going and keep the bad energy fire away. But I didn't know it was going to be a career thing.
Okay.
So I wasn't even thinking about, oh, I'm a musician or whatever. People used to like me in my community. They used to really like when I sing other artists' music. Like when Afrobeat started to pop, 2007, 2008, and we had Simaya, P-Square, Jim Martins,
nice.
All over the place. Nice. Dibange,
Two-Face,
right. The legendary Two-Face and all of that. You know, I used to bang that music, lip sync to that song.
Okay.
You know, everybody, it's single. I used to learn the music fast. So that was the thing, it was always in me, but
yeah.
I didn't really think it was going to pop up the way it did. But we give God the glory, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know, right? And the Liberian music industry.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if we do have an industry yet.
Yes, we do.
Okay. How has it been for you since you started? Has it been welcoming? Were there some like tough times? How is it like with other artists?
There's an industry in this country.
Okay.
But the thing is, people don't see a fit to call it an industry because they feel like there isn't much money and the brand is not that big.
True.
But trust me, once there is talent somewhere, when there are talented people, skillful people, people that are creating content, automatically you have an industry.
Sure.
You know, industry is not something where we have to say, oh yeah, we're better team for it. No, it's already there. When the structure comes, that's the time you get proud to announce to the people, oh, we have an industry. The industry is here, but there is no structure.
Yeah.
That's the problem. But the industry is here.
Okay.
The industry is something that is built within every content creator, every musician, actors, actress. We are the industry.
True.
For the fact that we are in the country, we are the industry.
And you're striving to make things work.
It's the structure that we don't have. Reason why people don't like to say, oh, it's an, you know, it's you know, it's an industry. The industry is here. It's just like, all right, this is a police station, right?
Yeah.
You have police boy in the country, right?
True.
This is a police station. But because every time you carry case there, because nobody there, you're in a police station.
people still say there's no security in the country, but then we do have.
We have police. Boom.
So that's it.
We have the police, we have the AFL, you know, we have different security all over the country. So why you say there's no security? Yeah.
So how has it been for you? Has it been welcoming?
It's challenging. You being a female, you know what I'm saying? It's very challenging, like everywhere around the world. It's my own observation, right? I feel like everywhere around the world, industry prioritizes male to the top. Once he's a male, when he come there and just do anything, once he blow it out, funny thing is, male artists in the industry don't have to do much.
Oh, that's it.
They
that's
don't have
true.
To do much.
That is so true.
They don't have to do much. Once they have the one song that hit before, they just be on that one song, one song, one song, and just keep dropping, dropping. And you know,
yeah.
even if the song is not a hit, people, it's always a hit.
Oh, it's
because you have
hit.
One hit before.
True.
That's how they treat male artists. But for a female, for somebody like me, especially somebody like me that's in the same line with these boys, the media always try to bring me down. You know what I'm saying? The media, there are certain people in the media always want to make Carol to be under these boys. You know, like, Carol is under these boys. No, I'm not under nobody.
Oh, no.
You know what I'm saying?
Never be.
I'm doing better than 90% of these boys. The media should stop playing with me. Like,
and
I'm
that's
King
something
Carol,
I like
you know
about you. Don't play with me. Don't play with
like,
me.
I've been beating the bias, breaking the bias.
Oh, yeah.
Doing a lot of stuff, you know what I'm saying? Since I came in the industry, it's like going to 4 years now. I've been consistent.
True.
Creative, consistent. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's there. The records are there.
Oh, yeah.
I don't have to fight for my spot. I don't do that. I don't fight people and say, oh, give Carol this, give Carol. No. I don't do that. Because there is no way in this country you will mention music. You will mention the rap music, the rap scene in this country, in this industry, in Liberia, and not mention King Carol. Unless if you have a personal issue with me. Because I made it. You know what I'm saying?
True.
I am the reason why people look at female artists differently these days.
True.
I'm not saying I'm the first. No. I'm not the first. There were people before me. And there will be people after me. But all I'm saying is my being here changed a lot of things.
And there's a legacy that's going to be left behind.
Right. My being here changed a lot of things. And I want for people to acknowledge that. I want when you sit now, you say, there used to be female artists before. How many female artists people used to know before?
Yeah, it's true.
There have been over 6, 7, Cookie, Skeet. One person that, one female artist in the industry that really had that in her name all over was Queen V.
Queen V, yeah.
Respect to her.
True.
Queen V, Davero. Uh-huh. Only because why? The only reason was because they were like with these boys, doing collaboration with these boys all over the place. That's how your name became because that's how the media do. The media always want you to be with these boys.
Yeah.
That's the only time they can give you your flowers. I'm not doing that. I'm not doing that.
So there are no collaborations?
I have collaborated with my male counterparts.
Okay.
But I'm saying I have made changes.
Yeah.
I have made, you know, I've set the path before anybody. I've not attached my career to any male artist before I'm King Carol today. No. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If you don't go and do collaboration like a whole year of female artists, the whole year, when the female artist drop 4 songs, the 4 songs have to be a collaboration. Why?
True.
No, you can't say that with me. My most popular song, Don't Ask Me, is not a collaboration. Cinderella is not a collaboration. One of my most talked about songs is a collaboration, Dudu with Christophe the Change. And that song does not even have a video. You know what I'm saying? You can know, I'm just saying.
Yeah.
The media should be able to give female artists, female entertainers as a whole, female content creators, their flowers. It shouldn't be making it about, oh, boys. We already trying to have a space here.
Yeah.
We are working 100% harder.
We do need a space.
The most of these boys.
We are capable
of
having
Why are you making it to look like every time, and I see people on blogs when they're posting about MC Carol and say MC Carol, like, bro, it's there, it's clear. Just say it. MC Carol is the best rapper in the country. Say that, it's clear. MC Carol has been consistent for 3 years, it's there. Don't say, this is so passing along with MC Carol. No. If you're talking about these other people, you're not saying along with MC Carol, or you're not saying MC Carol along with these people. You know what I'm saying?
True.
It's there, it's clear, say it.
So,
don't be afraid to say that.
So yeah, so that's an issue, and I think it's has been happening for a long time, and hopefully it ends.
It will end, because I'm not going to fight people to say, oh, give me this praise, give me this glory, but I'm going to work. My work will always
stand speak for you. True.
And every time you want to talk something that's not true about me or that's degrading, I will just show my work, and my work will talk to you. I'm not going to talk to you. I dropped the biggest album 2021, King Carol. With over 1 million streams in less than 6 months. Nobody has ever done that in the industry. Give me my props. Stop playing with me.
Stop playing with her.
And the album,
stop
since
it.
I dropped the album July 2010. This one is 7 months. I've never dropped any other single beyond the album. In fact, it's just picking up again. King Carol is just picking up again. I got Fuck All, I got No Feeling For Me, I got Sacha Cry, I got Cinderella. These are all hits.
True.
Playing all right, and I'm taking an album to 1 year. Don't play with me. I want to show you that that's an album. That's not something you can just drop.
And
that's an album.
Let me tell you, I love your vibe. Your vibe
that's
is
an
unmatchable.
Album. What are you talking about?
But the next question I have to ask is concerning Brandon.
Yeah.
How did you finally find who you are to brand yourself as King Carol? How did that happen?
What was the process? When you in the industry, when you come in the spotlight. First of all, I just want to say shout out to the person that brought me here today, Pills. She's the one who posted my video 3 years ago, my purple video. Everybody, this girl went viral. That video was crazy.
Oh, so it's and all it's, the pills she did that?
Yeah, she did that. I sent it to a lot of people, but she was the only one who posted it. And because of her, you know, it was an opportunity. She gave me her platform at the time, and I built my career on that.
Nice.
And I always like to tell people about her. People, the media, I don't talk about much.
Yeah.
She's one of the most consistent female artists in the country.
True.
She have worked with a lot of people, a lot of songs. She's one of the, she even became international before me. Yes, but the media, I don't talk about her much.
True.
I just want to give her a flower every time I have the opportunity, you know what I'm saying?
It's good to see females supporting another female.
So, talking about branding, when you get in the spotlight, right, when you get into the media has their own things they put on you.
True.
People want you to be some certain way. They want you to be certain way. They want you to do this. And I'm somebody, I'm quick to get uncomfortable if I'm not myself. I struggled with that for like 2 years, trying to be, you know, like,
what people want you to be.
You need to be professional.
Yeah.
You need to be corporate. You need to be like, Carrie, you are Carrie. You can, like, I'm just me. I struggled with that for 2 years. I couldn't, you know what I'm saying? Even with my dress code and everything, people want me to dress fully female.
Feminine.
I can't.
And that was like an
issue. And I'm not going to do that
again. That was like an issue that happened, and I think you got like cyberbullying.
Yeah,
and
the bullying me. Well, I try, but you know that bullying, it's none of my business.
Yeah, I mean,
you can bully me all you want. Like, I've grown thick skin. The media have, I don't know, but if I survive a lot from the media. I was bullied in the country for 2 years straight, man. Can you imagine that? And up to today, people still think they can bully me. I'm like, you're wasting your time.
It took me 2 years to get here. You're wasting your time.
You're wasting your time because you can't bully me. Like, if you talk about my body, oh, Carol, I'm too big. Is it your arm? Like, you don't want to carry that around? My arm. It's not even.
Your business.
Like, it's not even nothing. Like, I got bigger things I'm thinking about.
Better.
I want to be one of the most influential artists in Africa. That's what I'm thinking about. Big arm can't even stop me.
Like,
from
that's
doing
who
that.
You are. Like,
what are you talking about? I want tomorrow in the next 5 years when people see me. It's, if I leave from here and go to Tanzania, I do a big concert. And I bring out 20, 30,000 people. If I leave from here, I go to Nigeria, I do a big concert. It's not about Liberia. It's not just about Liberia.
Yeah.
Other people are out there waving their country flags everywhere around
True.
The world. What made you think that Liberia can do the same thing? We can.
We actually can.
Bonner we can
boy,
do the same thing.
Whiskey.
Everybody's
all
out
over
there.
The
all place. These boys, all these young boys. Rema, Fireboy, Joe Boy, you know, Tenny. All these children from Nigeria, from Ghana. They're out there waving their country flags. Liberia can do the same thing. Liberia been there.
Yeah,
it's not
been
new.
There.
And tell me other family and Zach and Jiba. They used to go to the country to do concert now. It's not new. We just starting all over again.
Yeah.
And I just pray this one that we are starting all over again. We should go, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
full
we shouldn't like go back. And
full force and everything. So people that are coming after us, they can begin from where we stopped. Not to take it all over again.
So in short, it took you like 2 years to get
to find myself.
Oh yeah, and I love you the way you are right now.
Yeah.
And you seem so very comfortable.
I'm comfortable in my skin.
I'm telling
there
you.
There is nothing you can
and,
tell me.
And that is the most important
thing. I
don't
care if I even go do some of Beyonce right now with Jet Jetty.
Oh, but yeah.
Like, that's me.
And that's your style, and it's unique.
Maybe I would just get a little bit for the camera, but I'm not going to do makeup, I'm not going to do lashes, I'm not going to do all of that. I'm sorry, but I'm not going to do that again.
We're done pleasing you
make
people.
Me very, very, right.
We're done
I'm
pleasing
done.
You.
Like, I can be, things like that make me very uncomfortable in my own skin. Like, I just, when I watch some of my videos, I'll be like, even
what,
though it's just a
what
video,
was
you know
I thinking?
What I'm saying? That's not even me. I like people to see the real me. That's me. For the fact that I am able to present myself to people with my true self, And you know, that's something that pleased me a lot. That's something that gave me reason to keep going. But why the media keep making me this, Kyrie, you need to wear heels. Kyrie, you need to wear dress. Bro, I stopped wearing dress for more than 5 years before I even became an artist. That's never, ever been my thing. Even growing up, I really never used to love this girly thing, you know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah, some so us struggling.
It's not easy for you to take somebody out of what they're comfortable in. Yeah. I know the media will say, oh, Kyrie, this is packaging. Bro, you can package me as a tomboy.
And that's
you
it.
You can package me as a
Amen
tomboy.
Amen to that, sister.
You can package me as a tomboy. If you're not able to package me as a tomboy, you just don't know the job. Forget it.
All right. So this is like really interesting. And like I said, I like your vibe. But we need to take a very short break. And when we come back, because you just you went to the U.S. and we need to talk about that.
Right.
Yeah, you went to the U.S. And the only thing I could hear in my ear when I wake up, like, don't play with me. Stop playing with me. So we'll talk about that right after the short break. Please do not go anywhere. Yena. Welcome back to the Yena web series. I'm Elaine Reeves and I'm with the one and only King Carol, the woman making hair waves in Liberia and even international in the US. So MC Carol is right here and this is a wonderful chat. I mean, her vibe is unmatchable. So before we could go for the break, I said I wanted to hear about your trip. First of all, before you could go, when you got your visa, it was a whole social media sensation. The video you posted, like, oh yeah, I finally got it.
Right.
And proud of that, you were like, oh yeah, please tell the people to get it. How was that experience for you, the beginning?
That was something very historical, because it was like after 5 years, mm-hmm. 5 to 6 years since a Liberian artist went to do tour.
Yeah, true.
A group of Liberian artists went to America and they didn't come back. So that was really stressful.
So was that affecting you?
Kind of.
Okay.
That was not really my problem, sir. It was about COVID. The embassy was not like operating fully.
Yeah.
Because of COVID. So our papers were in, and then. But we couldn't get an appointment.
How long was it in for?
It was like 3-4 months.
Whoa.
Yeah, but we couldn't get an appointment date. You see, like I always tell people, right? You see the social media? Mm-hmm. Like if you know me, you know that the social media made me.
True.
So I really use the social media to my advantage.
It's a good tool.
Right. And I've been telling people all the time, everything you put out here, if it's essential.
Yes.
People, I didn't even know the people at the embassy to follow me. Yeah. I thought I wrote that thing and like, I'm begging the government of Liberia to talk to the people at the embassy to, you know, allow us. We just want to go and do our tour and come back. And because my paper, I don't know, because my paper wasn't for long.
Yeah.
So that day when I was going for my interview, I was like, ah, God, I've been praying for it, did it, did not count. When I go down and I go to the very rich today. So I was like, nah, I'm hopeful, you know, I'm confident that, yeah, they will get my visa.
Yeah.
So when I went there, I met the counselor. Mm-hmm. And he was like, he asked me for some two different papers I gave to him. Like, he didn't even open it, but he was like, MC Carol.
Whoa.
A white man. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
So that man, no money.
And then you're
right there, I confirm him, and I'm like, it's over.
It's over.
Like, MC Carol. You know, he said it with so much excitement. Even though he's white, but you can know that he's saying my name like somebody that's been following me, that's been checking me out. And so we're like, ah. But nothing to worry about, Giro Caro.
And that's when it actually went viral.
Oh, yeah. And when I got it, I'm like, when he said, oh, come back Thursday for your visa.
That was easy.
It was very easy. He didn't ask me anything like, oh, the only thing, like, you know, he didn't ask me that, oh, don't run away. No, he said, if you go to America and your documents say you're going to do a tour. So if you go and you don't do this tour, you're going to do something different, you know, you can get arrested for that. And then you'll not be able to come back to America. I said, I know that. And he said, okay, you can come back since the time. He gave me, come back Thursday for your exam. That's great, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people went there. I was not the first artist.
Yeah.
They've been denying a lot of artists. True. It was great. The way the media dragged me for this thing. My tour was supposed to start in April.
Oh, yeah.
2021 in April and in July. April, May, June, July, August. So in August. Everybody's this girl not coming. Yeah. I was the first person. It was before Panto got added to this. And she got they dragged me. But you see, that's why I be telling people, if you want to get successful for yourself.
True.
You saw this people there? If you fail, they will laugh at you. If you get successful in whatever you are doing,
they want to identify with you.
Yeah. They don't care. They can go to any team they want to go to.
True.
But you are the main character in the whole movie, in the whole story. Whatever you do, do it for yourself.
True.
Pray for yourself. Work for yourself. Anything you do, do it for yourself. Because people will switch sides. Like, ah, the people now were dragging me online. When I posted, I said, ah, y'all get off visa. Like, you tell me, I didn't get off visa. I carry all this, you won't go to America, you won't visa. And most of these people were women. Imagine.
I know.
Most of these people were women. They said a lot of things to me. I said that one day, Jaya dragged me when I get my visa. I come down and see social media and put me in your faces. And that's exactly what I did.
Oh, yeah.
And so now I got my visa, I said, America, way. I said, America, way.
Everybody, yeah.
Oh, Gary, come for me. I said, you see, like, just everything you do, people, if you fail, people will laugh at you.
True.
If you get it right, people will come and sing with you. These same people. The Swiss every time. Anything happen though, you know, if you happen, if you get money, everybody will kind of want to enjoy
money.
If you go down there, they will leave it, they will cost you.
True.
It's just that. So whatever you do it for yourself. I was praying, I said, God, I know you're not missing. They don't put a dragon on the show. I mean, I want for you to prove yourself to them.
Yeah.
And I just go away and did it for me.
Easy like
I mean,
that.
I went to that embassy, man. I didn't, as I'm not even, I haven't known other people before, but the way that white man called my name, I knew. Because, and you know, the company now is sending for us. They said the people know we checking your social media to make sure what are you sharing the flyer and stuff like that. So one of them said MC Caro. I said, oh, yeah, it working. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And we went to the tour. You know, we went to America. When I got to America, it was crazy, man.
People loved me. The fans came out.
Bro, according to what I heard, what the tour artists say, other artists been going there to do show, but our tour was the best.
I'm a living witness.
our tour was the best. You can see from, I haven't even released my documentary yet. I put some little videos together.
We waited for that.
Went, all my small things, you know.
And the stop playing with me.
But actually, stop playing with me came from here.
Oh, from here.
Yeah, I've been doing that thing like as Master Queen, as Rixlin. These are people. Cypher the King.
Okay.
These are my people. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, stop playing, boy. Stop playing with me.
Stop playing.
It came from here. But because I was in America and people relate to it, meaning when I was
that, so, just
so
went
it
like...
just went viral. You know what I'm saying? Like, every time, stop playing, boy. Stop playing. Yeah, stop playing. And the girls didn't like it, so, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody like it, so. What's up, man?
I know, right?
We just gotta keep the flow going on.
Sure.
And the tour was good. Except to Labyrinth out there, you know, I tell people, right? Labyrinth people want to support the music.
Yeah.
Especially the fans out there. The fans out here, most of the time they just they just hail you.
Yeah.
They don't support financial. Let me, and I'm being very honest.
Let's forget about the financial aspect, even financial. The streaming.
That's it. It's the same financial, yeah. You know what I'm saying? But those people out there, they ready to go hard, man.
True.
I saw people, I saw girls in the crowd cry for me, stream and they cry real tears, bro, when I was on stage. I was there, what? So this is how important I am.
I know, right?
People will go crazy when I'm on stage. Performing the same very song I can perform here. And everybody be acting like, you know?
Yeah,
Hey, it's regular. I don't blame these people out here. Because we got an problem anyway, so, you know. But still, we are not the only poor country in the world.
Sure.
We are not the only country that have poverty. We are not the only country that have bad electricity. We are not the only country that experiencing whatever we are experiencing. We are not alone. There are other countries around the world that are experiencing the same thing we're experiencing.
Sure.
But when it comes to that entertainment, they go hard. Do you know how many things go in Nigeria every day?
A lot.
Kidnapping, murder, this and that thing. But when they say entertainment, they are number one.
Yes.
And the entertainment help the people to forget their sorrow, forget about the bad things that are going on.
They're supportive.
Yes.
They're very supportive.
And the entertainers are helping other people, things that the government not doing. The entertainers are doing it.
Sure.
Personally helping people, personally paying school fees.
Yeah.
Personally building and buying houses for people.
Endorsement deals, right? And all that.
What are you saying? The entertainment is really helping the population. So all I'm saying is if the country, if the people, yeah, support entertainment, the private people, our fans, everybody, Liberia as a whole, support entertainment, bro. Don't tell me I'm a millionaire in my community, the transformer blow up, I'll go wait for LNG to come.
I'm telling you,
I'm not gonna do that. I got money, I can pay for that transformer.
True.
And everybody enjoy LNG. If someone's facing our little community, road crack, I gotta wait for public works. You know what I'm saying? I get money. True. I can buy cement, buy quadra. We face that place. You know, keep the community moving.
And that's why empowering people or citizens.
That's what it means.
But
if you don't give me the power, if you don't give me the power to do these things, I can't do it. But when someone say, you're streaming our music, that will make money. And I follow what's said. And I follow the web fan.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Just a click.
And I just the web fan club, fan shoe, and all. To make impact in the community. I remember when Corona was hitting everybody here. Some interstellar get out, share rice, buy buckets. These are things that we will be
soap
doing.
Soap and sanitizer and all
right.
That.
I personally, I went out, I shared food. Even though I never really took it on my social media because I felt like it was a trying time for everybody.
Yeah.
It was not something to put out there. Give out money, give out the little I had. So if I have more money, imagine if I have more money, bro.
Oh, until
if I have more money, I'll pay school fees.
Oh yeah.
I'll pay rent. You know, I will help people. So if you empower me, I'll empower you back. That's it.
Give back.
Give back to the society.
True.
Yeah.
All right, so let's talk about your future plans. Tell us what's cooking.
I got something I'm working on. I'm working on a lot of projects, a lot of songs and videos. Like I said, this year and next year, I want to be talked about in Africa. That's the goal, you know what I'm saying? When I came to the industry 3 years ago, I said before I clocked 3 years in the library, I want for everybody to know about MC Cairo.
I want to do
things that female artists never did before. And I did it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So every time I tax myself, this is what I want to achieve in the next 3 years. This is what I want to achieve in the next 2 years. So right now, I want to be maybe one of the trending artists in Africa in the next 2 years. I'm Cigar from Liberia, you know? I'm Cigar from Liberia. That's who I want to be in the next 2 years. So that's what I'm working on right now. Okay. And that's taking a lot. That's taking a lot because you're going out there, you're going to meet a wider crowd.
Yes, different people.
People get different opinions about you. But it's not going to change me from being me.
Yeah.
I'm just going to put in the work, the creativity, the marketing strategy, promotion, a lot of money too, you know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah, money is essential.
Money is involved. A lot of money is involved. But that's what we want. That's what I want to do. That's where I want to be in the next 2 years. I want to be nominated at FEMA.
Okay.
You know, all the African top awards around Africa. Basically, I need to be there too now. You know,
it's not about this. It's not just about Liberia needs to go out there, not just here.
So it's not just about Liberia. So, all right. Like that.
So what can you tell your fans? There are a lot of them. Nationally and internationally.
I'm about to tour again, London.
Oh,
yeah, I'm
see?
Breaking news for you. I'll be in London anytime soon. So my fans in London, be ready. They can carry tour. It's coming outside. I'll be there. I'll be doing you few shows and performances. I'll be going crazy again. And after London, maybe another country will come and we're going to get a vibe there. So
yeah.
I just want you to keep streaming King Kairos, the album. That's the best album from 2021 up to present. No album in Liberia from... Let me tell you something, it's kind of secret. Let's see. The intro on the album, people were stuck on the intro on the album for like 2 months. Before even stepping to the next song. I gave you code, I directly blocked you, so no, it ain't like that. That album is really good. It's really good. I don't like to praise myself, but I need you to go...
Oh no, you need to toot your horn.
I need
necessary.
To go find the album. It's available everywhere, worldwide. On Spotify, Apple Music, Tidal, everywhere you can stream music from. Wherever part of the world you're in, just type MC Kairos and you'll get the album. It's really good. You need to enjoy it. It's an album, it's not a single. That's why I want you to enjoy it. I want you to put more time in listening to the tracks. It's 20 songs. Yeah, enjoy the album. I got more goodies for you, more good videos coming up. I still got 3 videos from the album to drop. The most anticipated song right now from the album, Fucker.
Oof.
Fucker is going crazy, man. Everybody know Fucker. So I want to drop a video for Fucker. Maybe No Feeling for Me and Sachi Kra will follow. But yeah, that's where we are right now. So enjoy yourself, you know. Follow King Kairos on all social media platforms. It's MC Kairos official everywhere. TikTok, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. And like bring people in town, go on Twitter now. Because Twitter, that's where we are right now.
It's the trendiest.
Twitter, that's where we are.
Everything's trending on Twitter.
Yeah, go to Twitter too. They have Twitter account. And don't forget, the best mobile money app in Liberia is Tipme Wallet. I'm using it too. You know, I'm using it. It will help me. So sometimes I want to give away. I can do giveaway with different things. Want to tip me. So if you get a Tipme account for next week, I'll start doing giveaway again. So you know, the start of day, till your 4:15, I'll be dropping your little GG. Hey, man.
That's
so
nice.
Download the Tipme app on Google Play Store and App Store. You can download it, and yeah. That's where we are right now. Stop playing, boy. We outside.
Stop playing.
We're
about
to take over Africa in the next 2 years. That's where we want to be. So, you know, it's more work, more creativity, more investment, more time, more everything. And shout out to all the people behind the scene, my label, my management, the media, people who support me, even the one that dragged me. You guys are very, very important. I love you. Thank you so much for the support.
There's no bad part for
is here today because you participated in making this name a household name. I love you and I appreciate you. Thank you so much for everything you do for the brand. Love you and love always.
Awesome. All right,
and
King
Big Kairos. Shout out to this. Big shout out to Heritage.
Yeah, the Liberian Heritage Society.
It puts me from all the way. Shout out to the Liberian Heritage Society. Thank you so much for a splendid interview. And I really like your vibe.
Thank you.
And, you know, I really don't vibrant interviewers in Liberia, but you give me good vibes.
Ooh.
Yeah. Thank you. And shout out to Heritage.
Stop playing with us.
Stop playing.
All right, so that's it. And it was really awesome to have
you
here.
Thank
and
you.
This is not the first and last one.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to more interviews with you.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, you know, we have to follow you, your 2 year plan. I dig it. And I want to be part of it.
Yeah. It's gonna be crazy. I'm telling the whole world now because I don't want to be happy and people say, hey, it's getting
nah, talk about nah, surprise nah. Now.
2 years from now, I want to be talk about in Africa. I mean, every word I say, right now. 2 years from now, I want to be talk about in Africa. I want people to know that there are talents they are creatives in Liberia. You know what I'm saying? It's not just about you go Kakata, you go Nimba, you can't sit down. Liberia music always, since after the war, we always been here. We need to step out. That's what we want to do. We want to take the challenge. It's a big break, but we are taking it together. With your support, your love, everything. Everything will compress. You feel me? Stop playing, boy.
Oh, yeah. All right. So that's it. And I hope to have her again in a few months or years to come. And this was awesome. Our vibe, we really clicked from the get-go. And this was fun.
Yeah.
So thank you so much for watching. Keep following Heritage TV and the Liberian Heritage Society. Yena, I'm Elaine Reeves. Until next time, bye-bye. London vibes.
I'm really bonus. No, really can, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You must stay there. Oh, la, 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 la. No, really can, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Kaka, you must stay there. Check and do your congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Come and do your congo. Come and do your congo. Check and do your congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Be down funny. This biggie man want to come run my race. Yeah. But I live one working full of the place. Yeah. Pass me the jail, let me feel the way. Let me feel the way. I like catching my head. I mean, the one where they talking about. Everybody wanna know where I'm at. Been on my ground, waiting for my time. I don't know why you just want me to die. Blazing the place, in the place, in the place. Blazing the place, in the place, in the place. Top in the top, in the top, in the list. What about you? Sina, Rela, can, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Kaka, you must stay there. Oh, la, 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 la. Sina, Rela, can, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Kaka, you must stay there. Check and do your congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Come and do your congo. Come and do your congo. Check and do your congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Come on now, baby. I just wanna tell you the one thing. Ever, ever saying I've been waiting. For your own fire, you jelly bluffing. Look at your fun, say, fun jelly your man. Fangele yo, I won't put my poo there. Chatting it around, chatting it around. Got me like, oh lele. Chugaju, see my fun, baby. Chugaju, baby, where be, baby. Chugaju, baby, where be, baby. Chugaju, got me like, no, really can, yeah. Oh, oh, can, yeah. Kaka, you must stay there. Stay there, stay there. No, really can, yeah. Oh, oh, can, yeah. Kaka, you must stay there. Check and do your congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go. Come and do your congo. Come and do your congo. Check and do your congo to go, go to go, go to go. Congo to go, go to go, go to go.